Alright, what's up guys? We're back with another Skyrim video. So, we have to talk to the Jarl about trapping a dragon. Trapping a dragon so we can get all the way to...
What is it that you need?
Sovngarde. I need your help.
I must have misheard you. I thought you asked me to help you trap a dragon in my palace.
Oh no, I did.
I'm sorry, but I can't do it. We'll just have to keep fighting the dragons as best
no,
we
no,
can.
No. You don't understand.
What you're asking for is insane. Impossible. You want me to let a dragon into the heart of my city? With the threat of war on my doorstep?
It is the only
way
to stop the dragons.
There must be another way. The risk is too great.
The threat is worse.
Alduin. World-eater himself.
Yes, he is.
But how can we fight him? Doesn't his return mean it's the end times?
It's only hope. Yeah, I like that.
I didn't say anything about giving up. Now what's this nonsense about trapping a dragon in my palace?
Alright.
I want to help you, Dragonborn. And I will. But I need your help first.
Alright, what
Ulfric
do you need?
Ulfric and General Tullius are both just waiting for me to make a wrong move. Do you think they will sit idle while the dragon is slaughtering my men and burning my city? No.
They should.
I can't risk weakening the city while we are under the threat of enemy attack. I'm sorry.
Oh, well, you don't have to worry about it anymore.
I would be glad to help you with your mad dragon-trapping scheme, but getting both sides to agree to a truce will be difficult at this point. The bitterness has gone too deep. Maybe. What of the Greybeards? They are respected by all Nords. High Hrothgar is neutral territory. If the Greybeards were willing to host a peace council, then maybe Ulfric and Tullius would have to listen.
Alright, that sounds like a good idea.
Now, if you don't mind, I've got a city.
Alright, so we're gonna go try to see if the Greybeards would help with this little situation about the war. Maybe even put the end to the war. Or at least enough time for us to just take a breather, maybe catch a dragon, go fight Alduin, then let the war continue. But as long as this war's going on, I'm not in a good mood. Because this war needs to be over, because I frankly don't want the world to end. I think I just heard a shout coming from the back. I think they're practicing. I think I just pulled that out. Hey, bud. You want to help me end
Alduin,
a war?
We heard the Dragon Wren shout from here. You defeated him?
Yes, but
I
he escaped.
I feared as much. I thought it was him we saw flying east after your battle.
Yeah, sadly.
We are not warriors. What is overlooked in the Dragonborn is not permitted to any other followers of the Way of the Voice.
Well, I mean, like, I need your help to
you
stop the war so I can catch
authority.
The dragon.
The Greybeards have never involved themselves in political affairs.
Yeah, well, I need you to now.
I see. The dragon will lead you to Alduin, but without the Jarl's help.
Yeah,
Artanax,
so we need both sides.
Has made the decision to help you. This is the road we have to walk.
Yes,
even
it is.
Even the Greybeards must bend to the winds of change, it seems.
Yeah, everyone has to change at some point.
Tell Ulfric and General Tullius that the Greybeards wish to speak to. We will see if they still remember us.
Alright, let's see. Let's see if they remember. Alright, let's go talk. Let's talk to Tullius first. I thought I'd been to some... Yeah, I have. It's just that the wolf makes it look like you haven't been there. Skyrim is home to the Nords, a fierce, hardy people that value honor and prowess in battles. God, you know, if you think about it, there's a lot of war in this game. There's like multiple wars going on. There's the Gondgard and the vampires, the Stormcloaks and the Imperials, the dragons and the humans.
I'm not interested.
And then there's another one in the DLC. The Dragonborn one. you have to go basically have war with the older Dragonborn. Alright, so I'm not joining this war. I am ending it right here and right now with Tullius. Starts and ends right here. Hey, Tullius.
Are my men now giving free rein to anyone who wanders into the castle?
Yes.
Do you have some reason to be here, citizen?
Yes, I do. I believe we've already met.
Have we? Oh,
yeah, remember
course.
You're about to behead me?
You were at Helgen. One of the prisoners, if I recall correctly.
Yes, I was. I need Havar, and he said he would vouch for me.
Havar's alive.
Yes, he is.
I hope that's true. He's a damn good soldier. But he hasn't reported in yet, so he can't exactly confirm your story. In the meantime, why don't you have a chat with Legate Ricca?
No, I want to talk to you.
I suspect we might have use for someone resourceful like you.
No.
Not many survived, Helgen.
Besides,
I'm sure your being imprisoned was all a terrible misunderstanding.
No, I need to talk to you.
Speak with Legate Ricca.
I have a message from the Greybeards.
What do those old hermits want with me?
They're conveying a peace council at High Rothgard.
There's nothing to discuss as long as that traitor Ulfric is in arms against his rightful emperor.
We need a truce.
They are getting to be a problem.
We
but
need a
I
truce.
I wasn't sent to Skyrim to fight dragons. My job is to quell this rebellion, and I intend to do just that. Dragons or no dragons.
You guys, the dragons are a bigger problem than the Stormcloaks right now.
I'll be the judge of that. Besides, by all reports, the Stormcloaks are suffering just as much as we are from these dragon attacks.
Well, it's this time to negotiate from a position of strength. Yeah, the Empire can't afford to snub the Greybeards.
I'm always surprised by how seriously the Nords take these things.
So you'll come?
Yes, fine. I'll come to this Greybeard Council.
Thank you.
For
it'll
all
mean
the
a
good
lot.
It will do.
Well, it's gonna stop the war until I'm done with these dragons. That's not.
Citizen?
Yeah. Oh. Well, I thought you were about to talk to me. Nah, you're just passing all by. Alright, so let's go. I actually haven't gone into Windhelm, but I've gone to the stables, luckily. Yeah, because I'm pretty sure I was traveling to. I wanna say. Riften? I don't know. Hey, but if you want to see the video I did it in, you can just head on right back if I didn't edit it out, because honestly, I don't remember. It's been a while. It's been a little bit of time. Hello, people. People of Windhelm. It is me, your Lord and Savior, Dragonborn. Oh, you better not talk to me. Please just let me in without a toll. Let me in without a toll. Good. On good stepping so far. Just come on. Oh, there's two guards. Okay, good. They don't care. Windhelm is open to the public. Scholars assume that generations of living underground re-rendered the Falmor blind. Over time, their senses have become more acute as a result. Never knew the Falmor were blind. You know, they always seem to know where I am exactly.
You come here where you're not wanted. You eat our food, you pollute our city with your stink, and you refuse to help the Stormcloaks.
But we haven't taken a side because it's not our fight.
Hey, maybe the reason these Greyskins don't help in the war is because they're Imperial spies.
Imperial spies? You can't be serious.
Maybe we'll pay you a visit tonight, little spy. We got ways of finding out what you really are.
Do you hate the Dark Elves? Are you here to bully us and tell us to leave?
Yes, I am.
You've come to the wrong city, then. Windhelm's a haven of prejudice and narrow thinking, unworthy of one such as you.
Looked like those Nords
Nothing
were getting
new
some trouble.
There. Most of the Nords living in Windhelm don't care much for us, but Rolf is the worst by far. He likes to get drunk and walk around the Greykwater yelling insults at us in the small hours of the morning. Oh, a real charmer, that one.
So why would anyone think you're
a
spy?
Some of these Nords will come up with any excuse to despise us. And it isn't just the Dark Elves they hate. They make a target of the Argonians as well.
Motherfuckers.
In fact, just about anyone who isn't a Nord is fair game for their bullying.
What are they?
We're one of the same kind, you and I. I'm glad to have met you.
Likewise. How can I leave?
Safe travel.
If anyone tries to bully me, I'm gonna beat the shit out of them. Can I talk to you?
I'd be out there fighting the Imperials right now if it wasn't for my war wound.
War wound? Why the fuck would I give him a
good day.
Piece of gold? That guy seems very nice. He's not a bully. Palace of the Kings. I like how they just let anyone go talk to their king. For all they know, I could be an assassin just coming here to kill Ulfric.
Ulfric won't give us a straight answer.
He's a true Nord. He'll come around.
I need to talk
to you. I remember
you.
You're at Helgen with us. Come to join the war.
No.
Speak with Garmar. He handles a new.
Oh, why does everyone just assume I want to join the war? No, that's not why I'm here.
I'm sorry to hear that. If you change your mind, speak with Garmar. What does bring you to me?
I have a message from the Greybeards.
It's about time they turned their gaze from the heavens back to our bleeding homeland. What do they want?
They want to negotiate peace.
I have the greatest respect for the Greybeards, of course. And the dragon attacks are a growing plague. But the political situation is still delicate. Not all the Jarls are fully committed to supporting me as High King. I can't afford to appear weak. I can't agree to this unless Tullius himself will be there.
General Tullius has already agreed to attend.
We still hold half of Skyrim despite everything the Empire could throw at us. I doubt the Empire has the stomach for much more bloodletting.
Alright, so you'll come?
Yes. I'll give Tullius one more chance to quit Skyrim with his tail between his legs.
Alrighty. Let's go. Let's go have the meeting. Let's go. Let's end this war.
He's against us.
Well, that's not true. Just because I'm an Argonian, that doesn't mean I'm against you.
It's no... The Aretino boy is doing some ritual, trying to call the Dark Brotherhood. But who's going to stop him? Me? I'll have no part of that.
I won't. Alright, so we are going here. The one-handed skill improves the use of weapons such as daggers, swords, maces, and war axes. Well, that's good to know. Alright, so I think everyone should be here. We're going to have to, if I remember correctly, we're going to have to negotiate, and I'm going to have to give land to the Stormcloaks and land to the Imperials, and so on and so forth. All right. Are you ready for this peace treaty?
So, you've done it. The men of violence are gathered here in these halls whose very stones are dedicated to peace. I should not have agreed to host this council. Greybeards have no business involving ourselves in such matters.
Don't worry, I'll get them to agree
peace?
To peace.
I doubt it. They may put their weapons down for a moment, but only to gather strength for the next bloodletting. They're
well,
not yet
then.
Tired of war. Far from it. Do you know the ancient Nord word for war?
No.
Season unending. And so it has proved.
Well, that's
but
not very uplifting.
Pointless.
That's not true.
Here we are. Take your seat at the council table, and let us see what wisdom we can find among these warriors of Skyrim.
Alrighty. What's up, bitches? I'm here.
So, Arngeir, is it? You know why we're here. Are you going to let us in or not?
Yes, take a seat. Take a seat. I said, take a seat. Sit. Say it. Well, what the heck is the Blade Lady doing here? I thought she hated the Greybeards. Apparently those who are Stormcloaks.
Now that everyone is here, please take your seats so we can begin. I hope that we have all come here in the spirit
of... You insult us by bringing her to this negotiation? Your chief Talos Hunter?
That didn't take long.
I have every right to be at this negotiation. I need to ensure that nothing is agreed to here that violates the terms of the White Gold Concordat.
She's part of the Imperial delegation. You can't dictate who I bring to this council.
Please, if we have to negotiate the terms of the negotiation, we will never get anywhere. Perhaps this would be a good time to get the Dragonborn's input on this matter.
Yes.
Ismir's beard. The nerve of those Imperial bastards, eh? To think that I would sit down at the same table with that.
Sit down.
Valmor bitch. Either she walks or I do.
What's the harm besides? Tullius doesn't really want her here either.
Maybe so, but bringing her here is a deliberate provocation.
Alright, take a seat.
Enjoy your petty victory. The Thalmor will treat with whatever government rules Skyrim. We would not think of interfering in your civil war.
Ha! Skyrim will never bow to the Thalmor. Unlike your Imperial friends here.
You're lucky I respect the Greybeard's council, Galmar.
Legate, we represent the Emperor here.
Sorry, sir. It won't happen again.
Now that that's settled, may we proceed?
I have something to say first.
Here we go.
The only reason I agreed to attend this council was to deal with the dragon menace. There's nothing else to talk about. Unless the Empire is finally ready to renounce its unjust claim to rule over the free people of Skyrim.
I knew he wouldn't be able to resist.
Temporary truce to allow the Dragonborn here to deal with the dragons, nothing more. I consider even talking to the Empire a generous gesture.
Are you done? Did you just come here to make speeches, or can we get down to business?
Yes, let's get this over with.
Are we ready to proceed?
Yeah, are we good?
Jarl Ulfric. General Tullius. This council is unprecedented. We are gathered here at the Dragonborn's request. I ask that you all respect the spirit of High Hrothgar and do your best to begin the process of achieving a lasting peace in Skyrim. Who would like to open the negotiations?
Yes, let's get down to it. We want control of Markarth. That's our price for agreeing to a truce.
So that's why you're here, Ulfric? You dare to insult the Greybeards by using this council to advance your own position?
Jarl Elisif.
General, this is outrageous. You can't be taking this demand seriously. I thought we were here to discuss a truce.
Elisif, I said I'd handle it. Ulfric, you can't seriously expect us to give up Markarth at the negotiating table. You hoped to gain in council what you've been unable to take in battle, is that it?
I'm sure Jarl Ulfric does not expect something for nothing.
Yes, that'd be entirely out of character.
What in return?
Wait, General, you don't intend to just hand over Markarth to that traitor?
This is how the Empire repays us for our loyalty?
Enough. First, let's be clear. This council wasn't my idea. I think it's a waste of time. You are a traitor to the Empire and deserve a traitor's death. But I at least will negotiate in good faith. Since we're all here at your request, I'd like to hear what you think Markarth is worth.
Markarth? About Riften?
The Rift would help secure our communications with Cyrodiil and threaten Ulfric's southern flank.
The Dragonborn has spoken, Tullius. Markarth will be ours. Now we'll see if there's anything behind your talk of good faith.
You disappoint me, Dragonborn. I accepted your invitation on trust in your good name. But it seems you intend to favor Ulfric. I can see now that this is not a negotiation at all. I know you, Ulfric.
If I hand over
Markarth, you'll be ready with a new demand. You'll never defeat the Empire, and you know it. But you're willing to sacrifice thousands for your own selfish ambition. Soon enough, I'll have you back under the headsman's axe, and this time there won't be any dragon to save you.
The Empire's fine words are worth nothing.
Stop! Are you so blind to our danger that you can't see past your petty disagreements? Here you sit arguing about nothing, while the fate of the land hangs in the balance.
Is he with you, Duffy?
He's got a good point.
If so, I advise you to tell him to watch his tongue.
He is with me. And I advise you both to listen to what he has to say before you do anything rash.
Don't you understand the danger? Don't you understand what the return of the dragons means? Alduin has returned, the World Eater. Even now he devours the souls of your fallen comrades. He grows more powerful with every soldier slain in your pointless war. Can you not put aside your hatred for even one moment in the face of this mortal danger?
I don't know about the end of the world, but this dragon situation has gotten out of hand. If this truce will help the Dragonborn here put an end to that menace, we both gain. Remember that, Ulfric. Now, back to the matter at hand.
You know as well as I do
that we can't hand over Markarth on these terms.
Show us bones. Where will these demands end?
Out with it, then.
We want compensation for the massacre at Carthwaisten.
You slaughtered the very people you claim to be fighting for. True sons of Skyrim would never do such things.
Damned Imperial lies. My men would never stoop to such methods, even in retaliation for your butchery at...
All the blood spilled in this war is on your head.
So, Dragonborn, what do you say?
Who's Ulfric should compensate? Yeah, with Karth Blaisen.
You'll actually pay for your crimes. I suppose that's the fairest deal we're likely to get.
I agree.
We may have an agreement.
I agree.
Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, these are the terms currently on the table. Markarth will be handed over to Ulfric's forces, Jarl Igmund will step down, and Thangvor Silverblood will become the Jarl of Markarth. Stormcloaks will withdraw from the rift, allowing Imperial troops unhindered access. Jarl Leyla Lawgiver will step down, and Maven Blackbriar will become the Jarl of Riften. The Stormcloaks will pay appropriate compensation for the massacre at Carthwaisten. You both agree to this?
The sons of Skyrim will live up to their agreements, as long as the Imperials hold to theirs. What about you, Elisif? Are these terms to your liking? Speak up! I'm sure General Tullius is waiting to do your bidding.
I have nothing to say to that murderer. General, you've proven yourself a good friend to Skyrim. I continue to trust that you will do your utmost to safeguard our interests.
I agree.
Thank you, Jarl Elisif. I appreciate your loyalty. The Empire can live with these terms, yes, for a temporary truce, until the dragon menace is dealt with. After that, Ulfric, there will be a reckoning. Count on it.
Alright, there we go. We completed.
We have a lot of work to do.
Giving up Markarth is a heavy price for this truce.
Learn the shower.
I anticipated the problem.
While you were arranging this meeting, was busy in the library of Skyhaven Temple, an unguessed trove of lost lore. But the important thing is that the blades recorded many of the names of dragons they slew.
Really?
Cross-referencing this with Delphine's map of dragon burial sites, I believe I've identified one of the dragons that Alduin has raised up.
How does that help
us? Don't you see? The names of dragons are always three words of power. Shouts. By calling the dragon the voice, he will hear you wherever he might be.
Alright, so...
He's not compelled to, but dragons are prideful by nature and loath to refuse a challenge. Your voice in particular is likely to intrigue this dragon after your victory over Aldrin. I think it's very likely that he'd be unable to resist investigating your call.
Alright, so what's his name?
Indeed. I'm no master of the voice, like these worthy gentlemen, but it is written here in the scroll.
Alright, thank you. Fiend. Old
Winged Snow Hunter, as I read it.
The Snowfall Dragon. I wonder if you can learn names of other dragons in the future.
I'm a little deaf in my right ear.
Alright, so now let's go to dragon research. So from there, we can... I'm going to actually buy some spells from, what's his face? Whoever the wizard up here. Like, Firebolt, I think, is one of them. Yeah, because I'll help, like, shoot him distance, because I can't do nothing with a bow. I suck with it. I can't do shit. And they're most likely flying around most of the time. You know, I could use Dragon Rend on him. I did just think of that. Bring him down, bring him to my level. Get on my level, dog. At Dragon Gate. Shit. Do I have to talk to the Jarl before I can do this? I'm guessing I have to.
The Greybeards have arranged a truce between the Stormcloaks.
Yeah, I do. Alright, so. I'd like to buy a spell. Aw, shit. Don't worry, I got some fresh batteries right here. Alright, ain't nobody stopping me from killing no dragon. Or capturing dragon, whatever it is. Alright, so what do you have for sale? Scrolls, Firestorm, alright, books. Oh, fast healing, yes. Fear, nah. Fire room, what's this? Cast on a nearby surface and explodes for 50 health points. Blast fire that is healthy and nearly takes. Can I even afford this one? Oh yeah, easily. Cast away nearby surfaces. Let's do this one. Crossbite, I feel like I already have. Healing hands. Reanimate corpse, soul trap, sparks. What's this? Lightning that doesn't. Nah. Steady fast, don't fit. Alright, yeah. I think I'm good. Alright, so let's learn those real quick. Books. Spells. Alright. I think we're good.
One of the new servants?
Alright, so are you ready to spring the trap?
My men stand ready. The great chains are oiled. We wait on your word.
Nice. I like it. I'm ready. Let's go trap a dragon.
Make sure you do your part.
Oh,
I'm putting
my
city in your hands.
You can trust me. Have faith, Jarl. No one knows who exactly built the Skyforge. I don't know.
Fiend!
Go ahead.
It's a dragon of yours. We're ready.
Big boy. Wait, come here. I know you. get this tasty ass.
I've been looking for you.
No.
Got something I'm supposed to
deliver. What the hell? I'm sort of fighting a dragon right now.
Let's
I can't talk
see.
To you.
A letter. Not sure who from. He wouldn't say, just that he was a friend of yours. Ah, a letter from the Jarl. Moving up in the world, eh?
Dude, I gotta go interrogate this dude. Let me go.
Ubona.
Hello.
You went to a great
take me to
deal of trouble to put me in this
yes, I
humiliating
did.
Position. In Sir Alduin, No doubt you want to know where to find Alduin.
Yes, I do. So if you could tell me.
Renikvaza, an apt phrase. Many of us among ourselves,
Of course.
Once Lord Grossus in New he has his Mindoran pa Okmedove Navarantil. I surely do not to Ulost Ofan Hinlan. Now that I have answered your question, you will allow me to go
for you promise to serve me?
Serve you? No.
What?
Need aid. If and when you defeat Alduin. I will reconsider. Grossis. There is one detail about Skaldafin I neglected to mention.
What?
Only this. You have the Thuum of a Dova, but without the wings of one, you will never set foot in Skaldafin.
And then fucking take me there.
Of course. I could fly you there, but not while imprisoned like this.
Oh, yes you could, baby. Yes, you fucking could. Fine.
Unikan Korav Gair Mirad. It is wise to recognize when you only have one choice.
Yeah, you do really only have one
and
choice.
And you can trust. Free me. Skaldafin.
All right. Hold on. What was that guy want to do? Is he want to talk to him? What are you doing?
Incredible.
No, you want to examine him, don't you? Alright, I'm going to wrap up the video here. So, we captured a dragon. We convinced him to take us to Alduin. And so I think I'm going to have to be able to kill Alduin in the next one. Alright, so I think the next one's going to be the last episode of the campaign. Now, I'm thinking about doing mods after this. Let me know. Alright, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.